Hey friends, do you want to see how easy it is to build, push, and deploy containers to Azure Web App for Containers? Now you can do it all with one command with the Azure Container Registry. Steve is here to show us how to make the magic happen today on Azure Friday. Hey folks, I'm Scott Hanselman, and this is another episode of Azure Friday. I'm here with Steve Lasker, and we're going to talk about a fantastic thing that I have been using myself. I did a couple YouTubes on it. ACR Build makes life better.
Yeah, we've been doing some work. We're basically trying to streamline the ability to build locally before you commit, then when it supports you when you do your commit code, and then afterwards when you're stopping your commit of your code, how do you patch containers? So we're thinking about that whole lifecycle management.
Yeah.
And I was watching that video you did a couple weeks ago when you were using builds and going to app service.
Well, and I was frankly using more gestures than I think I needed to, and it was probably a little bit of my own lack of education, but also not understanding some of the features that were available. So I figured we'd have you explain to me a really tight inner loop on making my life better.
Definitely. So that's what I wanted to show. So here we've got a project. I just did a really simple single page node app or single page, single file node app to show this out. And I simply am just going to mess with this little hello world here in the center. So with that file locally, normally I would have to do a Docker build. Right, then you tag it.
Right.
Hello.
Which I always forget.
Well, it's not going to go anywhere unless you tag it, right?
Mm-hmm.
And if you want some unique ID, which we'll talk about more as well.
Right.
And then you would say dot, right? Then you would have to say Docker push. Docker push?
And actually, I misspell Docker and I make it docket.
Yeah.
And I've actually made batch files and aliases to save myself from all
that. Yeah, there's lots of shortcuts. I actually was watching when you were going to do that.
Yeah.
So instead of having to do both of those, one of the things that we wanted to do was just build this into our pipeline. So now with the AZACR CLI, AZACR build dash T hello world, and for the unique ID, we can just grab the build ID from ACR build. And then I would say dot for the context and set it up. Now, because we're going to deploy to app service, I'm actually going to give it two tags, and we'll talk a little bit about that later. Hello world.
So one is generated and one is explicit.
Yeah, so when we think about the experiences with app service, and we have this other video we'll do on tagging best practices, we really want a unique tag to manage our deployments. We've had so many calls in ACR where people are struggling with trying to debug some inconsistency, and it turned out that they had inconsistent values for their images that was a single tag.
Right.
So it gave them inconsistent results.
Well, yeah, if you tag something or you mark it, whether it be in GitHub, we've all had experiences where one tag we thought was something, but we went to the explicit commit hash and it was the other thing. So you're kind of doubling up on best practices here. You're being explicit in two different ways.
Well, we actually want the release one to go away, to be fair.
Okay.
But the app service deployments right now only support that you can't update the tag as part of the webhook.
Okay.
So that's some work that we're working on improving.
Oh, so this is going to get even simpler.
It's going to get even simpler.
I like that. Simple is good.
And we did notice that PowerShell doesn't like those little curly brackets, so we'll just stick it inside quotes.
So the one is generated, and now this is interesting. The build is not happening locally here, which is important.
No, in fact, I don't even need Docker locally. You know, I might have problems with my configuration. We have one of our interns that are going to come with you.
You might have a machine that doesn't have Hyper-V.
Windows Home Edition doesn't have allowed Hyper-V.
I didn't even think about that. So, you're right. I do have laptops that have Windows Home, and now I can go and build my Docker stuff and deploy.
Yeah, so it's, and what's nice also is you will get complete consistency. So here I'm doing my inner loop, and I'm doing builds. When I do my Git commits, I'll use the same exact infrastructure, and then when I do release for OS and framework patching, again, it'll be the same. So here, and the thing that's nice also is we're still seeing the streamed logs, right?
Right, it feels local.
It feels like your local experience, and we have some pretty cool stuff that'll make this run even faster over time as well. So things one day just will start running just as fast as local. So while that's happening, one of the things we'll be able to see is, and it's actually, in fact, I'm just going to disconnect here.
So it's still happening, though.
AZACR build task logs.
Okay.
And if I don't specify one, it'll just give me the last one that's been executing.
Okay.
So we'll see it just stream out, and it's there you go. It's going to show me the whole log, and it's just finishing up now.
Oh.
And if we look, we'll drill into this more. You can see some the images we've built and the dependencies. So we'll talk more about this here in a moment. So now we've got that image, and in fact, we have the extension here for VS Code that supports ACR build as well.
Okay.
So I can just, well, this is under development, so this, I have to hit refresh for the whole thing.
Sure.
But if I go to demo 42,
right,
we see Hello World.
Yep. Oh, there's
we can
the release
see
a minute ago.
The release and the other one that I just built. And I could even see the logs here as well.
I see. So the curly bracket build.id, the build ID that was generated was unique in that case.
Exactly.
Was AAGU.
What am I? Okay, so.
Okay.
Something's going on.
And which registry you're going to use? The demo, yeah, do that and then hit demo 42?
I don't know why it's asking me that. Didn't used to.
That was in active development.
There's active development, yes. So we still have some work. And then you could see there's the tags. And then I can open the logs from here as well.
Mm-hmm.
So you'll be able to get all of that information locally. And we even got it in color. So anyway, we've got our build.
Mm.
We can browse the other images that are right here. I could even deploy to app service if I choose a particular tag. But I actually find it easier to do in the portal in this case.
Okay.
So we'll do that. And I think it demos a little better as well. So we'll come here to our demo 42 registry.
Mm-hmm.
We'll look at our repositories, and we'll see our Hello World one here as well as everything else.
Right, so there's demo 42, Hello World.
And I am going to use the release tag here. So I'm going to deploy to web app, and we'll call it Steve Lass.
Is that Hello. Always a new deploy?
When you deploy to web app, in this case, it actually is configuring a new web app, yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
But in fact, in this case, what I'm also going to do is deploy to an existing app plan.
Existing plan, okay.
So goes faster, and obviously I don't want to have to create each one of those each time because that's the thing you're paying for.
Exactly.
And down here, it was saying that we're actually going to set up a webhook for you. So what we're doing is you built your, regardless of how the image got in the registry, actually it doesn't really matter, you can deploy to app service, and by choosing that gesture, we will set up the web app. We'll set up a webhook so that anytime an image is pushed, it'll automatically do a deploy.
Mm-hmm.
And like I said, some of the things we're working on is making sure that we read the payload in the webhook for the new tag. This way you can always deploy unique tags.
Mm-hmm.
So we'll let that finish setting up here. The other part that we're doing is we want to be able to say we can easily build those images.
Mm-hmm.
And by stitching this pipeline together, you'll see that we'll be able to use the same command I had locally and have it automatically deployed to app service.
Exactly. And then I just have one command or no commands.
Well, yeah, it depends on what you're trying to do, right?
Yeah.
So we'll click this. It's going to finish doing the pulls. But I'll come back over here while that's loading. And if we look, we'll see the webhook is set up for us.
Mm-hmm.
And we'll see it hasn't fired yet because we have, oh, there, sorry, it's fired right there.
There it goes.
So those are the webhooks, and if we go to configure, we can see that for now, it's configured with just the release tag.
Okay.
Because that's all app service can do is a single tag right now. But you got your URL and all of that.
Okay. And that's why we needed that second tag, was to give it something to key off of when a new one got released.
Exactly.
As opposed to the idea of a latest, most unique tag.
Yeah. Latest is always a weird one, so I tend to use the word newest for the newest tag, or
indeed,
in this case I said release, but We'll save that for another conversation.
So there it is.
So here's our app that's deployed.
Mm-hmm.
But now we want to come over here. We're ready to make a change. You know, maybe we're going to say Scott because I'm not sure how to spell your name. So I'm just going to test this locally.
Okay.
So I've saved it. No commits. Well, I can still come over here and just say build again.
Oh, without doing a commit and really littering your Git logs.
Nobody has to know that I can't spell your name.
Nice.
Right? It's just, this is totally inner loop. I just happen to be doing my inner loop in the cloud. So it'll, again, rebuild that.
And then, of course, because you're being smart about your layering and how you created your Docker file, this small change doesn't necessarily, because of Docker layering, need to cause the whole world to build again.
That's some of the work that we're going to be adding in for the interim build caches.
Mm-hmm.
So that's not there yet. You will see that start to show up in ACR
build. There is Docker layering caching, but there isn't incremental build caching yet.
Not yet.
But that means that everything is just going to get faster, like you said.
Exactly. The same commands you're running just all of a sudden are going to start getting faster.
I love it.
So, but to your deployment, though, the deployment's sitting there. That's a running service.
Mm-hmm.
So when the webhook fires, it only has to get that last thin layer of changes.
This is nice because I know that I have a lot of messy commits and squash to hide them.
Right.
But ultimately, I want to see it in close to production, but maybe not necessarily. I want to run tests, but I'm not ready to commit just to run tests.
Exactly. Okay, so that's just about done. And actually, I'll show you another command here that's running. So here, I'm running this in Cloud Shell, mm-hmm. and I'm basically just watching the list of builds, and it refreshes every second.
Oh, okay.
So you can see that last one is a manual one because there's no task name mm-hmm. That it has completed. And there it is. And over here.
AZACR build task list holds and waits and refreshes every second.
Well, hold on. Let's go back. So what I'm doing.
Oh, you're doing a watch in front of it.
Yeah. So
clever.
You're going to see me switch back and forth between PowerShell and Bash here mm-hmm. because, you know, use the best tool for the job.
Of course.
And in this case, I can paste into an absolute Bash environment and watch this. So you can see the. Well,
What a clever idea. That's one more reason for me to spend time in the Cloud Shell.
They got VS Code in there now, too. So
I know, it's great.
It's really cool. Okay, so Scott,
Hello, world. Hello,
so
Scott.
I can't spell. So, I shouldn't say I can't spell. There are some people that actually spell their name that way.
There are, a whole country of them.
And it's the Stephen with a PH as well. So, I guess a whole country of them, yes, exactly. Okay, so we're going to now commit this. But before I commit, I want my builds to be based on Git commits. Mm-hmm. So, what I'm going to do is grab a snippet of code that I've got up here. Just because it's got a little bit more. Mm-hmm. And if we look at this, and I am going to come over to Bash and paste it. So what I'm doing here, there it goes, it zooms up. So now what I'm going to say is ACR build task create. So I'm going to create one that's going to tag it, hello world, the same way I did before. Mm-hmm. In this case, let me put the release on here as well. Oh, I see. I grabbed the wrong one. That's my other demo.
So you need your two tags.
Yeah. So let's go grab this one.
Right. So you're gonna let me see if I can read this real quick because you're moving fast.
Well, I'm gonna paste it in here for that's
right.
the right one.
Create a new task. Build a new build task. You've got that first unique hello world. You've got that temporary hello release tag. Mm-hmm. You've got the name of where it's gonna go to.
That's the name of the build task.
Right.
That's the resource name.
And then you've got your context where the source code is mm-hmm. is going, and then you've got your Git access token, which is very clean and clever of you. I have to give you credit for that. And then you've got a sub call to AZ to go and pull that secret out of the key vault. That's clean.
You learn this after having recordings. I got to change my key. I recorded it that way.
You know I'm copy pasting my secrets in there, and I shouldn't be.
So we'll create that. And so now what we have is we've got the build task that's actually set up for Git commits mm-hmm. and more. So we'll talk about that in a second. So now we'll just do Scott spelled his way because you're unique.
Mm-hmm.
And we'll push that. And when I come back over here, if I watch my build list again, where was that? There we go. What we'll see is that one we just created is queued up. You can see the task name, mm-hmm. And it's based on a Git commit because you can see we have this trigger column. So that thing will queue up. It will start its build, and we can actually come over here,
mm-hmm.
AZACR build task logs, and we can stream the latest one. What is it? AHD. And it started to run. So we'll be able to see this kind of spew out here.
Mm-hmm.
But now this is the mode, right? If you happen to be committing to that code as well,
right.
Every time you're committing, that build's going to kick in. App services, listening for webhook notifications, and ACR build will go send it off.
All right, so there you go. It just started up.
Yeah, so it's, we've got our build queuing up just like we saw it before, and that'll run, and we'll see that complete. But as, like I said, it will just automatically trigger a deployment. So let's go back. We'll just watch that finish up there for a moment because mm-hmm. it's almost finished. Right, you can see the layer exists. Okay, so our build's complete. And what we can do if we come back over here, because our webhook was triggering it, if I just refresh, we could see that that has been updated for a Git commit.
Mm-hmm.
So that's stage two.
Mm-hmm.
Stage one was pre-commit. I can do my builds,
right.
Have it automatically.
No Git commit, but still got to see it in production or
right.
in development
or
production.
Or maybe another slot in App Service,
another
and I can
slot,
do it there.
Indeed.
Then I just start doing my commits. I'm mm-hmm. using the same build server. Now, the last one is what's interesting here is if we go back to my project, and if we notice that the Docker file actually said, not that one, this Docker file actually said from base images node in my my own repo, because mm-hmm. this is a corporate scenario. I'm managing my own base images because right. I want to control how my patches are applied to my my apps in my company. Mm-hmm. Well, if I come over here and I edit this one, and you'll notice I can change the background color. What's your favorite color?
Purple.
Purple.
Visual Studio Purple.
I haven't tried purple, so we're going to see how this looks. This could be horribly wrong, but it'll be make my point.
Yeah, indeed.
So now that was that has been committed, and notice here, I've got my base image node has right. just been They're triggered with a git commit.
Right.
And what we'll see here in a moment is once that's done, mm-hmm. the Hello World app is actually going to start rebuilding. Mm. Because what we've done is we have linked up the dependencies. So if you look here, there's a runtime dependency to base images node in the demo 42 mm-hmm. and that specific tag. So now we're monitoring that, and that'll work within ACR. It'll actually work on Docker Hub. So mm-hmm. if you're taking the dependency straight from node, that's fine too.
Okay.
It's just a little harder for me to demo updating the public node image.
Sure.
And that would trigger on as well.
So how tight is our inner loop now compared to what you saw me doing as I was bumbling my way through learning about building?
Well, I'm also happy to say that the bug you tripped on, we fixed also. That was just a DNS caching bug.
Sure.
Because as we do demos, we delete our registries every time.
Well,
a good bug to find.
I apologize. What had happened, my friends, was I was on YouTube and I was deleting and creating and deleting and creating things in quite short inner loop there, which isn't something you would typically do, but you might do it in a demo.
Well, you might have some tests that you're trying to test some infrastructure.
Yeah, so
I
was tearing the whole thing down and putting it back up again, but certainly that's fixed as well now, which is nice.
So that was cool. So here we've got our builds that are running, and if we notice now, we can see our image update, and we've actually have three. Mm-hmm. Two, the second one is actually another bug. This is a preview feature that we're finishing up. Because we tagged it twice, mm-hmm. we figured you really wanted to be notified twice. So
indeed.
Minor bug, we'll go back and fix that. And when that finishes, we'll actually see this thing deployed here in a moment. So mm-hmm. it just looks like it just finished. And there's your purple, which isn't,
boom.
I like my monitor better, actually.
Yeah, it looks pretty bad. It's okay.
But that's kind of the point.
Fortunately, we can change it in very quick succession. Though.
Exactly. So that's kind of what we wanted to show there with ACR Build and App Service, is really that quick three-step process that mm-hmm. you can do things very quickly. And the idea is, you know, I know John Papa's got the other one where he did AZ Web App Up, he's been talking
yep.
about, and that is awesome.
So in what is this, the stages of this is available? Is this ready? Is this in preview? Can I use it today?
ACR Build, and we're actually going to start calling it ACR Tasks, is in preview today.
Okay.
We're going to be adding some more capabilities so you can do things like doing unit tests as part of that,
okay.
so you can actually do running of containers. And the same model, pre-commit, mm-hmm. then you could commit them, and then you can do OS and framework patching. So it's in preview now, and we're looking to GA it very soon.
So then I should go back and redo my video with this new information and see how much more smoothly that possible.
We can certainly try that. I'm sure you'll find
something
Fantastic.
Else we should work on. I'm building containers in the cloud here on Azure Friday.